Bugg here, and I'm getting ready to enjoy the fireworks. I'm going to put my seatbelt on so you don't hear the ding of the car. You probably hear the fireworks in the background. Good friends are shooting off an excessive amount, if you can't hear it. So, good God, we're ready for this year to be over. So with that, I'm going to be looking towards next year, and I'm going to kind of share with you guys some of my personal goals as kind of an accountability, and then we can look back on it at the end of 2021, which I guarantee will be better than 2020. It has to be quite frank. So one of the projects I want to complete for 2021 is going to be my short series that is going to be published on Chameleon. So that site is very big on fiction. I had to pitch to their executive board. They have accepted. They're very excited about the concept. And it is inspired by my buddies at the cigar bar. And I'm going to leave it at that. But they're definitely my inspiration for the topic, especially Gerard, in a conversation we had about what if we had an end of the world situation, you know. So it's going to be very dystopian, it's not kid friendly, okay, not at all. So that's one goal. My second goal is I want to continue to publish regularly on Medium. That has been very successful for me this latter half of 2020. I would like to commit to publishing between 3 and 5 articles a week in long form. And I would, you know, I've been curated, which is phenomenal. And I've been selected as a top writer in the disciplines of economics and parenting, which I'm so happy about. I love my children. I love my daughters. And to kind of be a top writer in parenting, it's like, oh, I'm doing something right. So I would actually like to branch out from those and pursue some other disciplines as well and see if I have the same results. So my economics work has really taken off. I did get to partner with a military academy, which was very exciting. I'm going to be assisting in their project for their officer training manual, which is really cool because I'm a civilian, and so it's super cool. I'm very excited about that. We're going to be doing a continuation of the Words to Know short form series. So that will be on YouTube, TikTok, as well as Medium. And then that will later be compiled into an anthology, which will be available on Kindle Direct, which is so exciting. I'm so excited about this whole thing. I do have several freelancing clients that I am working for. 2021 will probably be my last year of editing and freelancing, just because my own personal projects are now starting to supersede the others. And as T.I. says, I need my stuff to be in existence in perpetuity, okay? So I'm so excited about this. Additionally, there are going to be 4 books that come out from me this year, which is a huge amount. I don't know if you hear the siren, so I guess somebody's driving drunk already. So there are going to be 4 books, maybe 6. 2 of which are fiction, and 2 are nonfiction. The 2 that are nonfiction are a part of a series that I'm entitling The Untied States of America. The premise is as if each individual state is a country, and what those countries would look like. Who would their trading partners be? What language would they speak? What would their vibe be? Would they be a first world or a third world? And it's really kind of expanding upon the idea of, you know, if states had more power, what would that actually look like? What would it, you know, what would that do? So I'm really excited about that project. One of the fiction books that I will be completing, and that should be done, I'm thinking the end of January 2021, is actually inspired by Devin, by Princess Devin. We are actually writing a piece. He is the inspiration. It is about a fairy goddaddy who is very bad at his job. And he doesn't like it, and he wants to be another mythical creature, but he unfortunately cannot be because he sucked too bad as a unicorn, so he got demoted, unfortunately. So that's one of the fiction pieces. The other fiction piece is semi-fiction. It's more of realistic fiction, and it's kind of discussing very much the people back home. I'm originally from Kentucky, so we're going to be talking a lot about, you know, their plight at the turn of the 20th century, And so it is based on facts, but there is a lot of fictional liberty with that, which I'm so excited to tell. It's going to be the story of, you know, tenant farmers and, you know, people who don't come from the right families and whatnot. So that's going to be a cool book. I think that that one's going to drop in August. So, you know, got a lot on the table. Obviously, I want YouTube to grow. It's, y'all have been so good to me. I'm seeing, you know, just growth every day. It's kind of overwhelming, to be honest with you. I do want to have more brand partnerships, which would be fantastic. And then also I want to begin doing live chats where I can answer your writing questions. And additionally, I also want to be a little more focused on this channel because I think I have a tendency to kind of just talk about whatever. And so going into 2021, I definitely want to narrow down. We're going to focus on reading, writing, media, and entertainment. That is going to be kind of our thing. So there's going to be book reviews, TV show reviews, movie reviews, how to write. We're going to feature new authors. It's going to be amazing. So I'm really excited about that. And then I think I had another goal. I want to win Emoji Blitz. I have been so dedicated to this game, and I want to win. It is for 7 to 8-year-olds, Disney Emoji Blitz. That is my kind of not professional goal, but personal goal. So that's going to be super fun. We all have to have a fun, you know, goal. We can't always be working all the time, because what fun is that? So I definitely have a lot of publishing goals and a lot of content-related goals. And you all are kind of going to be my accountability partners. So with that, thank God we survived 2020. It was such a rough year. I think it tested all of us. Not a single person I know came out unscathed by 2020, me especially. But I think it redirected some of us into, you know, what do you really want to pursue? You know, you don't have all the time in the world, and, you know, what did Eminem say? Life's too short to not go for broke. So, and sometimes you go for broke and you end up not. So that's kind of cool. So everybody, I hope you have a happy new year and a good 2021. Feel free to like and subscribe at the bottom, and I will see you guys probably tomorrow.